Welcome back to the channel. My name's Dan, and with Emily, we're Ramblin' Ambition, and we're working on our 2019 Sprinter van, which used to be an Amazon delivery van that we're turning into a little tiny home on wheels. So this December's been a little bit crazy. Over Christmas, we were in the single digits, and now as we approach New Year's, it's almost 70 degrees outside. So I thought I'd take the time to install these. So these are Sumo Springs, made for the rear of your Sprinter van. I put the Super Springs on in a previous video, put a link to that, which helps the spring pack out. These are going to take the place of the factory bump stops, which are right there, and basically that's what rides on the axle when the suspension compresses. So the point to these springs is that basically it helps to eliminate the body roll because these vehicles are so tall, and once you weight them, the body has a tendency to roll quite a bit. And I'll take the factory springs out and show you a comparison of what the difference is. And then these will compress a little bit to help stabilize the ride some. So it shouldn't take very long. They basically slide in and out, and it should take us just a few minutes. All right, there is the factory spring or factory bump stop. So they come out really that easy. So all I did was just put some force on it. So we'll get the other side and then we'll show you the comparison. All right, so you can see the difference in height between the factory bump stop, and it's supposed to compress in the center. And there's another comparison. So this sits on the inside on the axle tube itself. And so as the body rolls, this is going to come in contact with it and keep it from rolling so much. And they do have some carrying capacity too. The part number for these are SSR 33047. Now they do make a set for the front, which I think we're also going to add in, but let's go ahead and get these installed underneath. They should go in just about as easy as they came out. So we'll get started with that. So just something to note, you can see how this is flush and this has kind of got a notch in it. This is the part that goes in the rear. So facing the rear of the vehicle, this goes in first and then you pop the front side in. So the place where the notch is goes toward the rear of the vehicle, and that gets inserted all the way, and then you pop this in. All right, we're gonna take the notch, and I was afraid of this. So right now, the suspension is compressed quite a bit. So we're already sitting too low. So we're gonna go ahead and jack the vehicle up. All right, so we just put a floor jack under everything. And again, the notch goes to the rear. So we're gonna push that all the way to the end. And then they say take a screwdriver and force in the corner. There it goes. Oh my God. All right, so I took this in and pried in and then poked it up, and that seemed to work pretty good. So we'll repeat that on the other side and then let it down and see what it looks like. All right, so notch. Holy crap. All right, so you can see there are contact in the axle right now, and that's okay. That's how it's supposed to sit. Getting them in is a little more difficult than it seems. You just got to remember to put the notched in toward the back and then figure out a way to pry one of the ears in like a corner at a time and then just slowly work your way in. So even with the frustration, it, you know, this whole process took 20 minutes and it wasn't that hard, and it's really supposed to improve the amount of body roll that you get, especially going over terrain changes, whether that's a transition in the roadway between your driveway or between an entrance to a business, or whether or not you're rolling off-road and you've got some uneven control or uneven surfaces. This should help limit the body roll of the van. So pretty excited about it. Simple install, hope you guys got something from the video. This is Dan from Ramblin' Ambition. I'll put links in the description below for everything. Check out the rest of our videos and our channel as we continue on with our build. So we're putting cabinets in now and getting ourselves ready for a trip coming mid-January. It's kind of unexpected, but we're really excited about. So thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.